Hi, my dear students. Now, I'm going to give you a speaking activity. Together, you can just give a call, WhatsApp call to your friend and you can do this. My dear students, this is how you have to do this. When you are in the school, make a karanam karanne, menna mehemai form groups and narrate a similar folk story from Sri Lanka or from another country to the class. Class එකට ඉදිරිපත් කරන්න තමයි තියෙන්නේ. Right, you just have to write. Sinhala ජන කතාව නම් දන්නවනේ. You just try to translate it. මේ වගේ අන්දරේගේ කතා. You all have අන්දරේස stories. You all have so many stories. Not only in Sri Lanka. There are so many. What? There are so many stories from all around the world. You just have to write down a story like this. It means Sinbad Diwage story kalliyanna, and then you have to present it to the class. Now you just yalo denne ekathula story ekak call ekak katha karagena liyanna. You just have to write it, and then you have to record the story. You have to speak it with your friend. You have to record it anyhow. Then you can send it to the group of the class. You can share your ideas then. If we have 40 students, there may be 20 stories that we can listen. Okay, good, my dear students. You have to do it. That is the speaking activity that I am giving to you all. Now, I'm going to do collective nouns. Collective nouns. දැන් අපි nouns කියලා lesson එක ඊට කලින් කරලා තියෙනවා. Collective nouns. Collect කරපු nouns set එක ගැන තමයි කතා කරන්න යන්නේ. When you are reading this paragraph, you found some phrases එකට ලියලා තියෙන. ඔන්න බලන්න. Now I'm going to tell you why we are using collective nouns. Passe mangaṭa example tikak dennam, then you can understand what collective nouns are. We use collective nouns to bring a group of people or group of objectives together. Group of people or group of objectives together. මිනිස්සු කණ්ඩායමක් හරි මොන හරි දේවල් ගොඩක් හරි එකට එකතු කරලා කියන්න we use collective nouns. Right. What are the examples? I'm going to give you some examples. A litter of puppies. A herd of cows. A bunch of flowers. On a litter of puppies, a herd of cows. අපි කියන්නේ මොකද්ද? බලු රංචුව, බලු රැළ. ඊට පස්සේ හරක් රංචුව, හරක් රැළ. Bunch of flowers, මල් පොකුර. මල් ගොඩක් එකට එකතු කරා ඒක ගැන කියන්න ඉංග්‍රීසි noun එකක් හදනවා. A bunch of flowers. That is called a collective noun. ඔන්න collective noun. You just read some paragraph. You just take a newspaper and read. And you have to find out what? Collective nouns. එහෙමනම් the words in bold are called collective nouns. මෙන්න බලන්න මෙතන a litter of, a herd of, a bunch of, a පටංගත of වලින් එවනවා. මෙන්න මේ කැලි ටික තමයි අපි කියන්නේ මොනවා කියලාද? collective nouns කියලා. A loaf of bread. තේරුණේ දේ විදිහට. තව තියෙන a flock of pigeons. A bunch of ripe bananas. ඉදුණු කෙසෙල් අවරිය. අවරියට කියන්නේ අපි bunch මයි. A bunch of. A loaf of. A litter of. A flock of. Those are the collective nouns. You try to find out some more collective nouns, my dear students, and write a list of collective nouns. Take out your writing books and write a list of collective nouns. That's how you have to learn alone. Because nowadays we are going to make a student-based education system. You have to find out. You just read books. You just take a dictionary. You just read newspapers, English newspapers. You just browse the internet. You can find out lot of collective nouns. You write a list of. Now the homework that I'm giving you is write a list of collective nouns. Okay, my dear students, let's wind up the lesson for now.